make Mysore style Bisibele Bhat. The ingredients we need for Bisibele Bhat are
around 3/4 cup of rice, 1/2 cup tur dal, 3 to 3.5 tablespoon of our homemade Bisibele Bhat powder, small lemon sized tamarind, and soak the tamarind in water, little bit of jaggery, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder, 10 to 15 curry leaves, 2.5 teaspoon salt. We need 2 tablespoon of oil and a tablespoon of ghee, 1/2 tablespoon mustard seeds, pinch of hing or asafoetida, around 1/2 cup of shredded fresh coconut. If you don't want to use the coconut, that is fine, but it gives taste to the Bisibele Bhat. I have this 1/4 cup of dried peas. I soak that in the water. 1/4 cup of dried peas will give around 1/2 cup of peas after we soak it overnight. If you forget to soak it, it's fine. If you have a frozen peas or a fresh peas, you can use the fresh peas too. The vegetables, I am using around 30 to 35 green beans or handful of green beans, 1 to 1.5 carrot. I'm using this size carrot, 2 small size potatoes, 1 small onion, and I'm using this kohlrabi or navel koso. So this is the one, I feel it is important. It gives a better taste for the Bisibele Bhat. And remember, I'm not using tomatoes or capsicum. If you use that, the capsicum will take away all the flavors, whatever we are expecting in Bisibele Bhat. So I'm not using capsicum and tomatoes here. And of course, we need around some 6 cups of water.
First, I'm going to wash tur dal and the rice in a different pans. For this washed rice, I'm going to add 2 cups of water. The rice has to be a little bit softer. So I'm adding, for the 3/4 cup of rice, I'm adding 2 cups of water and keep it aside. And for this dal, I'm going to add around like 2 to 3 cups of water. And for that, I'm adding this piece, turmeric. I'm going to cut the vegetables. I'm going to cut the beans around this size and add this to the washed dal. Carrot around this size. Potatoes this size. Navel koso. I'm going to take out the skin. Again, we are going to cut this same size of the carrot. Actually, this Bisibele Bhat is a wholesome meal. You have varieties of vegetables, and we have carbohydrate, we have proteins, and we have right amount of spice in our Bisibele Bhat powder. Onions. Add the water to this cooker, around 2 to 2.5 cups, and keep the rice and keep these vegetables and dal. I'm going to keep this cooker on stove and let it whistle for 2 to 3 times on a medium high heat. Turn off the heat and let it cool. While we wait for cooker to cool down, I'm going to grind coconut, Bisibele Bhat powder, soak tamarind along with the water, grind it to a fine paste. You may need to add some water. Now we have this fine paste ready. The cooker has cooled completely and we have this paste ready. I'm going to transfer this to a bigger pan, adding a little bit of water. Take out all the masala and add it to the Bisibele Bhat. Turn on the heat for medium high. I mix this well. I'm going to add salt, jaggery, curry leaves, and let it boil. Now this is boiling. I'm going to add this cooked dal and the vegetables. Mix, and this is like a sambar consistency. So we have to add a little more water. Let it boil for another 5 minutes so that the vegetables will absorb the salt and the masala from the powder. Adding a half tablespoon of oil. Now add the cooked rice and mix it well. And for the flavor, I am adding a tablespoon of ghee. It is optional, but adding the ghee to the bisibale bath will give you authentic flavor. This should be the bisibale bath consistency. For the half cup rice and half cup dal, we can make a big pan of bisibale bath. Now it has been another 4 minutes. I am going to turn this off and our bisibale bath will not be complete until we give the seasoning. Heat around 1.5 tablespoon of oil on a medium heat. Now this oil is hot enough. I am going to add this hing or asafoetida first and the mustard seeds. Once that mustard seeds pops out, I am going to add this chilies. The mustard seeds are popping out. I'm going to add the red chilies and turn off the heat and put this on the bisibale bath. And this bisibale bath is ready. Our tasty Mysore style bisibale bath is ready to eat now. You can eat this with raita or bundi or anything, or you can just savor it with ghee. And I hope you enjoy making this bisibale bath. And please subscribe to our newsletter at foodandremedy.com. Thank you.